Hello students, welcome to the video tutorial for class 12 informatics practices. In this tutorial we will be covering the curriculum according to the 2020-2021 session. So let's begin. Your first unit is data handling and the first chapter under this unit is working with NumPy. NumPy you have already studied in class 11th, so we'll be having a revision of that chapter. So first of all, let's have the look over the contents. We are going to have introduction to NumPy arrays, creating NumPy arrays, its working and the applications. So let's start the introduction part first. Array refers to a named group of homogeneous elements. Now the term homogeneous here refers to the similar type of elements. That means whenever you are talking about array, whatever the data type is there has to remain same overall. That means if you are using int data type, all the elements in that array will be of integer type, and if it is float, then obviously it will be float for all the data types. Now NumPy is a function used to create arrays in Python. So for fulfilling the purpose of array in Python, we need to have a function called NumPy. NumPy here stands for numeric Python. Syntax for creation is numpy.array. So for creating any NumPy array in Python, you have to use this function numpy.array. We'll be having a brief introduction about NumPy array later on for the creation of that NumPy array. Basically, there are two forms of NumPy arrays. One is the 1D array, which is also known as the vectors, and second one is the multi-dimensional array, which are known as the matrices. Now remember one thing, 1D array, that means one dimensional array, and multi-dimensional, that means 2D array, 3D array, or how many dimensions are there. It all will be covered in this multi-dimensional arrays. Now moving on to the indexing part of this, we have already studied list in class 11th, and the indexing in the arrays is almost similar to the list. That means the indexing part is started from 0, then sequentially 1, 2, 3 and etc. Now moving over to anatomy of NumPy arrays. Anatomy basically here refers to the parts of the NumPy array. That means what are the functional unit in this NumPy arrays. The first thing is the axis. Axis here is the plural form of axis. That means multiple axes are to be covered in this. Second one is the rank, third is the shape, and next is the data type, and the last one is the item size. Now talking about axis, axis refers to the dimensions. That means whenever we are making any NumPy array, the dimensions are to be covered in this axis part. Axis is equals to 0 is the first axis, and this first axis runs along the rows. So how many rows will be there in the particular array, that all will be clarified using this axis. Axis equals to 0. Axis equals to 1 is the second axis, and obviously that will run along the columns. Now every new dimension which is to be added is going to get the next sequential axis number. That means if you are going to add the next dimension, it will is going to get x is equals to 2. Now let's suppose we are having an array here. The data elements are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So in this we are having only one axis, and the first axis is going to get the axis number 0. Now suppose we are having another array. Here obviously we are having two dimensions. Now the first dimension will be known as x is 0, and obviously it is consisting of two rows, and the next axis is the axis 1, which is covering all the columns. The number of columns in this are 5. Rank, number of axes in an AND array. Now if you are watching it carefully, you are having two arrays in front of you. The first one is having only one axis, so that means the first array is having only one rank, and the second one is having two axes, that means the rank of the second array is 2. Shape, the number of elements about each axis. Number of elements about each axis means, for the first array you can see in axis 0 there are 5 elements, so the shape of the first array will be 5, and in the second one axis 0 is having 2 elements and axis 1 is having 5 elements. Data type, also called the D type, and it refers to the data stored. That means type of data has to be clarified in this. That means if the data is of integer type or the float type or char, etc. Item size depends upon the data type. That means if the data type is int, it will have the item size according to the int, and if it is float, it will have the data type size according to the float. Now let's have an example here. A1 is equals to numpy dot array 1 2 3 4. That means here we are going to have a 1D array, whereas in A2 is equals to numpy dot array 2 4 6 comma 1 3 5, here we are going to have a 2D array. Now let's have a look how these elements are to be filled. For A1, elements will be filled as 1, 2, 4, and axis is equals to 0, that means this axis. And for A2, elements will be filled as axis is equals to 0, this one, and axis is equals to 1 for this. Now if you write A1.shape, let's have a look at this. The A1 is having 4 elements, and according to the shape, shape refers to the number of elements in each axis. So for the first array, axis 0 is having 4 elements and there is no axis 1. So accordingly, the shape will be 4 comma blank, because axis 0 is having 4 elements and there is no any other axis, so it is blank. For A2, axis 0 is having 2 elements and axis 1 is having 3 elements, so the shape will be 2 comma 3. Next, have a look at the rank of A2 array. Rank is the number of dimensions, if you remember. So for A2, the rank is 2 because there are 2 axes. Now A2.itemSize. Now we will be having a detailed introduction about the item size also later on, but right now we can mention here that since all the elements in A2 array is integer type, so the default integer size is 4, so the A2.itemSize will be 4. Okay students, so this is enough for today. We'll be having a next lecture.